called the Zhongnan Central Elevator Design and Use of Elevators for Evacuation.
那大家下午好，我是来自近思建筑咨询公司的廖世荣。今天下午我们跟大家分享的主题是苏州中南中心电梯系统以及电梯的疏散设计。
And I'm hoping that most of you, can you hear? It's working?
No.
Okay. I'm hoping that most of you has already known about the Zhongnan Center in the past couple of days.
那在过去的这一两天，大家也已经听了很多关于中南中心的报告，所以我觉得大家对这个中南中心多少也有些了解。
So I'm going to talk about the building functions very briefly and then get into the elevator design.
那我会很简短的再介绍一下这个中南中心的功能的一个分区，然后呢就进入到我们主要讲的这个电梯的一个设计。
Zhongnan Junction is located at the northwest corner of the Jinja Lake, about 10 minutes from the Suzhou city.
那这个中南中心呢是位于这个金鸡湖畔，然后呢距离这个苏州古城只有十分钟的路程。
And it is part of the master plan development for the central business district.
那这个呢它也是这个苏州 CBD 啊发展的一个非常重要的一部分。
And the building is located at the southwest corner of the development.
那我们这个中南中心的建筑就处在这个苏州 CBD 的西南角。
Right there.
就是这个图片当中圈出的中南中心的西南角。
With the subway line going across the
development. 那它的北部呢，北边就是这个苏州市的地铁一号线。
The building is a very simple, elegant square building with stepping corners.And a little curve to the exterior curtain wall, and a crown at the top of the building.
那整个建筑的设计外形呢是非常简单的这样一个方形，然后呢逐步收紧到顶端，会有一个这个塔冠在顶冠在顶端。
And the building is divided into 9 zones plus 5 level basements.
那整个这个塔呢分成了九个功能分区，然后有五层的地下。
137 levels high above ground.
那地上呢，一共是137层。
There are 7 functions.
那它一共有七大这个功能。
Observations at the top at level 137.
那顶端也就是这个137楼是一个观光台。
7-star hotel at zone 8 and zone 9.
然后第八区和第九区是一个七星级的酒店。
Luxury apartments at zone 4, 5, 6 and 7.
那第四区到第七区都是这个高端的公寓。
Zone 3 is the SOHO office.
那这个第三区呢是这种SOHO的办公室。
Zone 2 is Class A office.
那这个第二区呢就是传统的办公室。
And we have a ballroom and conference center at level 7 and 8 of the podium, Zone 1 podium.
那么在这个群房的这个七层和八层呢是这个宴会厅和会议室。
And retail at level 2 to level 6 and basement B1.
然后这个二楼到这个六楼还有这个地下一层是零售的商业区。
So the building is 137 level tall, and we could potentially has up to 28,800 occupants in the building in any point in time.
那整个这个楼呢有137层，那到最多的时候，整个楼中可以容纳超过28,800个这个的人数的容量。
So the vertical transportation system, particularly the elevator, is vital to the use and operation of the building and the safety of the occupants.
所以这个整个楼的垂直的运输的体系，特别是这个电梯，对于整个楼的这种运作和使用来说，还有包括里面人的安全来说，都是非常重要的。
So how do we design an elevator system to work for super tall buildings like this?
那像对于这样的超高的建筑来说，我们是如何来设计电梯系统的呢
？So we look at the area of each function.
我们会看到，我们会关注每一个区域的一个功能。
How do we establish the occupancy load?
然后我们会关注我们如何安排这个一个容量和承载量。
What's the actual populations of each function?
还有每一个区域呢会有多少的人数
？The attendance rate.
还有这个会这个出席人数的这个比例会是多少
？And five-minute handling capacity, like how many people can be handled within 5 minutes time?
还有五分钟的这个承载的能力是多少
？Which comes to a equivalent demand of 12% or 7% or 10% depending on the function。
然后呢，根据各种功能会使用多少的需求量，是5%、7%还是12%？
So we also look at the interval of the elevator system. How much time does people need to wait for the elevator to arrive?
还有呢，就是电梯使用的一个间歇。
What is the right speed of the elevator?
还有电梯的速度是多少
What are the right quantity or number of elevator for each particular function?
那每个功能会需要多少数量的电梯
And how many floors does each elevator will service?
那每一个电梯会服务多少楼层
How high does the elevator rise?
还有这个电梯呢会最高上到哪一层楼
What's the traveling time?
还有乘坐电梯的时间
the cost,
成本
the level of services,
还有服务的这个层数
and also how much space is really available in the building core to put all these elevators
还有呢就是整个这个塔的这个核心的区域会有多少的空间可以让我们安装电梯
So in order to develop the occupancy load we use 11 usable square meters per person for the office density
那么在这个办公区呢我们这个估计的是大概每一个人需要11个这样可用的11平方米的可用的空间
1.5 people per studio or one bedroom unit
那每一个我们估算每一个这个卧室或者是每一个这样的 studio 里面是 1.5 个
2.5 people for the two bedroom unit
那么这个两个卧室的这个公寓呢是 2.5 个人
3.5 people for three bedroom
那三个卧室的这样公寓呢是3.5人
and 6 persons for the 4 bedroom above
那么在四个卧室以上的这样公寓呢是6个人
and the target interval is 45 second maximum
那我们设计的这个间隙的时间最大是45秒钟
as for the hotel we are using 1.75 persons per hotel room plus 20% of the population
那对于酒店的这个功能区呢我们是每一个这个酒店的房间里面是1.75个人加上20%的这个客房的人口
because there are amenity facilities for the hotel area
因为这个酒店的区域有这些附属的设施是可以有这些客房
and our interval target is also 45 second maximum
那也是45秒钟的间歇时间
so now let's look at the elevator design of each function
那我们看一下每一个功能区的电梯的设计。
I want to explain this diagram a little bit before I get into the detail.
那先跟大家介绍一下现在这个大屏幕上这个图。
The table on the left represents the floor level of the tower of the building.
那左边的这张表格代表的是不同的这个塔楼的楼层。
And on the right, all those columns represent each elevator's.
那右边的这个每一个柱状呢就代表是一个电梯
and each dot represents the stop of each elevator
那这个有点的那个代表的是它会在这一层楼上面停留
so for the Zhongnan retail we have about approximately 23,000 square meter of gross area
那所以对于这个区域呢这个的职能区是零售区域我们的整个的这个空间是23,000平方米
And we provided a total of 9 passenger elevators.
那我们一共提供了九个这个客用的电梯。
And 6 service and fireman lift.
那六个这个服务的和这个在火灾的时候使用的电梯。
And we have 4 rooms and conference center at level 7 and 8 of the Zhongnan podium.
那么这个呢是一区这个群房七八楼的这个宴厅和。会议室
with gross area of approximately 15,000 square meters
它的总面积大概是15,000平方
with occupancy at about 1,600
那它的这个人数呢大概是1,600人
so we provided 6 passenger elevators and 3 service and fireman lift
所以呢我们提供了六个客用的电梯和三个这个服务的电梯
and the goal is to have everybodyAt the conference, depart within 30 minutes time.
那我们的目标呢是这些所有与会的这些人可以在30分钟之内撤离。
As for the Zone 2 office,
那这个是第二区域，就是办公区。
We studied different options for the elevator design.
那我们提出了这个电梯设计的几种不同的方案。
So we look at direct elevator which stops at every floor, which is the option A.
我们看到这个方案 A 就是在每一层楼都会停留的电梯。
Double decker to stop at every floor as shown on option B.
那这个这个 B 方案呢，也是在每一层楼都会停留。
But option B requires two-level lobby.
但是这个 B 方案呢，它要求的是这个大厅是两层的这个大厅。
We also look at having a shuttle elevators to a sky lobby, and then transfer into local elevators.
那么也会有这种方案，是从这个顶层直接直达到这个办公区域的这个二层的这个地方，然后从二层再转到这个它的其他的这个一般的电梯。
Enough.After various and many different generations of options and design, it was determined that the best solution for the Zone 2 office is to have direct elevator and divide into two zones, low zone and high zone.
那我们在比较了几种方案之后，最终的最好的方案是将整个这个区呢分成了低区和高区。
So option D is what we have elected to go ahead.
那么最终我们决定的方案就是 D 方案。
As for Zone 3,SOHO office.
这个是第三区的这个 SOHO 办公室。
We did similar study like the zone 2 with two zone of elevator, two group of elevator, the low zone and the high zone.
我们跟这个第二区的方案是类似的，也是分成了低区和高区。
And also the double decker solution.
还有这种双层的这样的解决方案。
And finally, we determined that having three shuttle elevator to a sky lobby.And transfer it into a local elevator, four local elevator, is the best solution and give the client the most flexibility.
那我们最终决定的方案呢，就是会有一个直达电梯直接到这一层的这个初始层，然后从这个大厅层呢，再转到整个 C 区的专门用的电梯，这是最好和最灵活的一个方案。
So for the zone 4 and 7 of zone 7 apartment,
这个是第四到第七区的公寓。
Yeah.Plus, primary two different distinct options.
我们呢有两种最初有两种初始的完全不同的方案。
One is to have direct elevator to each level of the apartment.
一种方案呢就是有这种到每一层的直达电梯。
Which can be grouped differently into four different groups, two different groups or three different groups. But in this diagram, in option A is shows a group two zones.And two groups.
那这个呢？但是要将整个这个四到七区呢分成不同的组。那在这个方案 A 当中是将这个楼层分成了两组。
However, to maximize the building efficiency and also to minimize the size of the core, we also study having shuttle elevator into a sky lobby and transfer to a local elevators.
但是为了能够最大化整个楼的这样一个效率和减少使用的空间，我们最终决定的也是从底层有一个直达电梯到达这一区域的一个大厅，然后再转到这一区域的专属电梯当中。
And it found out that it's the best solution for the core, as well as budget-wise, it's a cost saving.、
那这个方案呢，对于这个成本和对于空间的节省来说，都是最优的一个方案。
While maintaining the same or equal amount of service.
然后同时呢，它又没有。对这个服务的质量和服务的数量有所减少。
So for the hotel, zone 8 and 9 hotel,
对于这个八到九区的这个七星级的酒店
it is very straightforward.
这个呢电梯呢就是非常的清晰非常明了的一个使用方案。
Because of the height,
因为这个高度在这里。
So shuttle elevator is being used to go to take people,from the lobby to the sky lobby at 104.
所以呢，就是我们会有一个直达的电梯，从这个一层的大厅把乘客、把这个游客啊，或者是旅客直接运到酒店的大厅。
And then transfer to four local elevator, which stop at every hotel level.
然后呢，到了这个大厅之后，会有这一区域酒店区域专属的四个电梯，然后会在每一个酒店的楼层有所停靠。
And we also provide two shuttle elevator.At 18 meter per second speed for the observation.
那同时呢，我们也提供两个这样直达的这种快速的电梯。
In addition, we provide three dedicated service elevator for the seven-star hotel.
然后呢，我们对这个七星级的酒店也专门安排了三个这个服务的电梯。
And we have an extra size freight elevator that services the entire building.
而这个高层的呢，我们有这种对这个电梯的规模也是不一样。
This diagram kind of summarizes the elevator system based on the design criteria that we talked about earlier. I'm not going to get into detail of this table because we are pretty tight on the time.
那这张表格呢，就是展示整个电梯方案的各种数据的细节。由于时间的原因，我就不一一跟大家做介绍。
So overall, we have 91 elevators.And 26 escalator for the entire project.
所以整个的我们这个项目当中一共是91个电梯和26个扶梯。
One of the things that we did to reduce the core area and also the increased building efficiency, we stacked all the local elevator on top of each other.
那为了节省整个楼的这个核心的一个空间和提高这个效率呢，我们将所有的这些每个区域的专属的电梯是在一条直线上面互相是互相叠加的。
As you can see in this diagram, here we have Zone 8 and 9 hotel local elevator.
大家看这个表上，这一区域是这个八九区这个酒店的专属电梯
，which are located right above the apartment local elevator.
它直接是落在了整个这个四到七区的公寓电梯之上。
With the same shaft, although it's separated at the peak level.
它们是这样互相直接叠加在上面。
Which then are over the Zone 3 local elevator.
然后下面呢就是第三区的这个专属电梯。
So to do that, we were able to save a lot of area within the core and minimize the core area.And the size of the core.
那么这样的话就很大的节省了这个核心筒的这一所占的这个空间。
So we have total 91 elevator, and 60 of them started on ground level. So to locate 60 elevators on level one is a challenge, and it has to be located relative to the building entrances, which again is related to site development and site planning.
那刚刚。
Sorry.
刚刚提到我们一共呢有91个这样的电梯，其中有60个是从这个整个塔楼的一楼开始上升的，所以要在这个一楼的这个区域呢安装60个电梯来说是一个挑战，同时也要考虑到整个这个建筑和楼的入口和出口，这个也要跟整个建筑的平面设计有所关系。
And just going back to the previous slide, you can see on zone one, if you go across and count the number of elevators, it's about 60 of them. As you go up to the tower, it gets reduced. And then right at zone nine, we are reduced to about 10 elevators.
大家可以在这个表中很清晰地看到，在第一区的话，看到这个电梯的数量大概是60个，那么再往上呢是越来越少，那么到顶层的时候，大概到这个酒店区域的时候，这个电梯的数量大概是10个。
So for this building, we have the hotel entry on the loft with the express elevator pretty much at the center of the floor.
那大家在这个平面图上可以看到，从酒店的入口进来之后呢，中间这个核心部分就是这个快速的电梯。
The apartment entry is on the west with the express elevator at the upper left corner of the floor.
那么这个在西面是这个公寓的入口，入口进来之后会有这个公寓的电梯。
Zone 3 and Zone 2 office entries at the south.With the Zone 3 express elevator located at the west, Zone 2 elevator located at the south and east corner.
我们看到从这个南面进来的是办公的那个入口，那么三区的办公入口就是刚刚绿色的那个区域，在整个的西边。那么在南面和东面是这个二区的办公室的这个快速直达电梯的入口。
The retail entry is totally separate from the tower.Because of security and number of reasons. And it's located at the southeast corner of the site and the property, right under the podium.
看来，由于这个安全和其他原因的考虑呢，这个零售和商业区的这个入口跟整个大楼的这个入口是完全分开的，它处在整个这个平面图的这个东南角。
So now let's take a look at the use of elevator for evacuation.
我们看一下这个电梯撤离的时候的一个情况。
We have the building is 137 story high.
整个这个塔楼呢，刚刚介绍到有137层高。
Potentially up to 20,800 people in the building.
那最多的时候可以达到超过28,000人。
And based on the computer modeling.By our fire consultant RJA.
那么根据我们这个，我们与我们这个防火方面的专家和合作伙伴 J 进行了合作，他们给我们做了这样的模拟。
It would take about 2.5 hours to evacuate the entire building.
那他们做的模拟呢，测算出来，如果想这个撤离整个清空整个大楼的人数的话，大概需要2个半小时。
Even most of people are healthy.
这个呢是在前提的考虑呢，是这所有人都是正常人，都是健康的。
But what about the disabled and the elderly?
这里面还没有考虑到说会有残疾人或者是有这个老年人的情况。
So the use of elevator for evacuation is crucial for a super high rise like this.
所以呢，对于这样超高的塔楼和建筑来说，用电梯来这个撤离是非常关键的一个用途。
So how do we determine how many elevators?Do we need to use for egress or for evacuation?
那么对于这种在撤离的时候，我们怎么来安排这个电梯，然后使用多少电梯呢？
So based on the height and the function, we estimate about 90% of the people at Zhongnan, which is located 500 plus meter high, will be using elevator for evacuation.
那我们经过
egress.
我们这个测算在紧急情况之下，在九区，也就是他们处的这个楼的高度大概是500米以上的，在紧急情况之下，他们是会使用电梯撤离的。
80% for Zone A occupant.
那么对于第八区来说的这个是80%的人。
70% for Zone 5, 6 and 7.
那五六七区是70%。
60% for Zone 4 occupant.
四区呢是60%。
And 40% for zone 3 occupants.
三区呢是40%。
And we also assume most of people, if not all, at zone 2 and zone 1 will use stair for egress, with the exception of the elderly and disabled, which the firemen lift can be used.
那我们这个假设呢，在一区和二区的大部分人在出现紧急情况的时候，不会使用电梯或者走楼梯。那这里面当然不排除会有这个残疾人或者是老年人。那么在这种情况之下，他们会使用这种防火或者是服务的专门电梯。
So this is approximately 20% of people potentially are using or depending on elevator for egress and evacuation.
那么这个整体呢，就是说大概在出现紧急情况的时候，会有这样多的人口他们使用电梯。
So in order to look at the elevator for evacuation, we first look at the elevator operation system.
那我们首先要看一下电梯的一个操作系统。
And we identify primarily there are 4 different conditions for the elevator operation.
那么电梯的这个操作呢，我们是基于四种情况。
The first one is normal operation.
第一种呢是正常运行。
The second one is when there is no power.
那第二种呢是停电。
The third one is if there's a fire at certain location of the building.
那第三种呢是这个楼当中的某一个楼层或者发生了火灾。
And the non-fire condition.
它呢就是非火灾的紧急情况。
I'm going to go through this real quick because time is coming up.
时间这个快到，所以我很快的过一下这个。
So for the power failure condition, it could be in one zone or the entire building.But the bottom line is, whenever there's a signal from the electrical room, it would give signals to the electrical, to the elevator master control system, and tell the system to go into an emergency room, which brings all the elevator down to the ground floor.
那么在出现停电的时候，这种停电有可能是一个楼层停电，或一个区域停电，或者是整个大楼的停电。那么在停电的时候，将有信号传输到整个这个楼宇的信息集成系统。到这个系统之后呢，它会将这个信号传到所有的电梯，将所有的电梯降到一层。
And it depending on the extent of the power failure, the emergency response people will determine if the building will remain operation or shall they start the evacuation process.
那么会根据这个停电的具体的严重情况来定，这个楼宇里面的管理人员会决定说这个楼是正常的继续使用，还是说整个楼会进行撤离。
So for the fire condition, it could be one floor that has a fire, one zone has a fire, multi zone or the entire building.
那么火灾呢？我们将它分成了一层楼的火灾、一个区域的火灾、多区域的火灾，还是整个大楼的火灾。
The key thing and the bottom line is to bring all the elevator down to the first level to be controlled by the building management or the emergency response personnel.
但不管是哪种情况，这里面核心就是将所有的电梯降到一层，然后将会由整个大楼的管理人员来控制电梯。
And for the same token, when there is a non-fire emergency evacuation condition, such as bomb threat or terrorist attack.
那么对于这种非火灾的紧急情况，原则也是一样的。这种紧急情况，比如说是这种恐怖袭击，或者是这种炸弹的威胁等等。
And it normally have two different conditions. One is with fire power, one without power.
那这里面呢有两种具体的大的情况，一种是这个楼宇里面还有电，一种是已经停电。
So we provide a total of 11 elevators for evacuation or to assist the evacuation. Two for Zhongnan.
那我们呢，一共是安排了十一个这种专门辅助这个撤离的电梯。那九区是有两个
，two for zone eight，
八区是两个
，two for zone six and seven，
那六到七区是两个
，two for five and seven five，
四到五区是两个
，and three for zone three，
三区呢有三个。
As a result of using 11 elevator to assist evacuation, we are able to reduce the evacuation time from 2.5 hours.To approximately 1.5 hours.
那通过使用这样十一个电梯来辅助撤离的话，我们将整个大楼的撤离时间从两个半小时减少到了大约一个半小时。
So, Suzhou Zhongnan Center is one of the tallest buildings in the world, and it will have one of the best elevator service.
那么最终的这个苏州的中南中心建成之后呢，将会是全世界最高的建筑之一。那它也将会有世界上最好的电梯系统。
Thank you.
谢谢大家。
Thank you.